Well, I'm sitting there wondering, will the matchbox hold my clothes? Man, I'm sitting there wondering, will the matchbox hold my clothes? Ain't got no matches, got a long way to go. True love, your love, they give me true love. Your love, our true love, baby, that's what you give to me. That's just a snippet, a little section of two songs, Your True Love and Matchbox by the legendary rockabilly artist Carl Perkins, recorded on December 4th, 1956 at Sun Studios, Memphis, Tennessee. Now, that would have been the only song, two songs that he would record that day, that would have been enough. Carl used his band to record those two songs, which featured his two brothers, Jay and Clayton, along with their drummer, Fluke Holland. But there was a special guest in the studio that day, a session player by the name of Jerry Lee Lewis. Jerry Lee Lewis was an up-and-coming artist at Sun Records who would soon leave his mark on rock and roll. His nickname was the Killer, which I believe was given to him by his mom. Jerry Lee Lewis was from Faraday, Mississippi. He came to Sun Studios to be a session player, which means you just played on other people's recordings and got paid for it. He was an up-and-coming artist, and within months of playing Carl Perkins, he had his first big hit, a whole lot of shaking going on. So here you have Carl Perkins and the legendary Jerry Lee Lewis playing together, but it doesn't stop there. He was known as the Man in Black. Johnny Cash is the undisputed king of country music. But back on December 4th, 1956, he was still a young man trying to find his way. Sure, he had hits such as I Walk the Line and Folsom Prison Blues, but on this day, he was just down at, happened to stop in at Sun Studios, just do a little business with Sam Phillips, the owner, and to hang out with his buddy, Carl Perkins. He listened to the playback of Matchbox Blues and Your True Love and gave Carl the thumbs up and just hung out for a little while. So there you had in the studio, Carl Perkins, Jerry Lee Lewis, the legendary Johnny Cash. But the story doesn't end there. This is Elvis Presley. He is the king of rock and roll. By December 4th, 1956, he was basically long gone from Memphis and Sun Studios in that he was recording with RCA Records and was putting out songs such as Heartbreak Hotel and his first record, and his career was just taking off. But on this day, December 4th, 1956, he was cruising around Memphis. He was home for the holidays from his tour. He saw the cars parked in front of Sun Studios and said to his girlfriend, "Hey, there must be something going on over there. Let's stop in and say hi." So they parked their car and walked in the studio, and immediately they were greeted by his buddies Johnny Cash and Carl Perkins and the owner Sam Phillips. He'd never met Jerry Lee Lewis before, but that was his introduction. Elvis listened to Carl Perkins' playback of Matchbox Blues and of Your True Love, and he loved it. Gave Carl a thumbs up and thought they were fantastic. So they hung around and talked for a while. Eventually, they made their way down to the studio, and they began to play piano and pick up instruments and just started playing songs together and had what's called a jam session. Just playing songs together that they all know, mostly gospel songs and some early rhythm and blues songs, for 2 hours. Johnny Cash, Carl Perkins, Jerry Lee Lewis, and Elvis Presley perform together. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, may I introduce you to the Million Dollar Quartet. So here you have it, the Million Dollar Quartet. It wasn't dubbed by them. It was dubbed by a Memphis newspaper, and I'll get into that a little bit later. So, you have Elvis Presley, he's sitting down here at the piano, the king of rock. Can't see the piano here, but we'll have other pictures in this presentation. We have Johnny Cash, who is the undisputed king of outlaw country, better known as the Man in Black. He's not wearing black hair. Eventually, he started wearing black later, but he did have black hair. Carl Perkins, the king of rockabilly, and Jerry Lee Lewis, the killer. Jerry Lee Lewis with his pumping piano. And so they just, like I said, they just jammed and played together. You see, Carl has an acoustic guitar. Eventually, he handed his acoustic guitar over to Johnny Cash. Carl Perkins' band members were still there. They kind of played along a little bit. It was an impromptu jam session. Nothing was planned. They played songs they knew and loved, mostly gospel tunes, rhythm and blues songs, songs they made up, all kinds of different things, probably about 30 to 40 songs total. This was not planned. It was one of those things that just kind of happened. And sometimes those are the best moments in life, when they just kind of happen and no one planned anything and they wind up being great things. So Sam Phillips, the owner of the studio, saw what was going on. He knew there was something special happening. He went over and he thought, opportunity knocks. And he went over and he turned on his tape recorder and started recording the session. Now, the microphones were not anywhere close to them. The microphones were set up for Carl Perkins' session. You see, he was recording earlier on Matchbox and Your True Love. So when you listen to the recording of this, it is a little bit distant, but that's okay. He wanted to document this. Also, what Sam Phillips did is he called a local Memphis newspaper. They came down and they took some pictures and shook some hands and hung around for a little bit, and then they left. The boys kept playing together, and eventually Elvis was the first to get up and leave, and then the rest of them left and they never thought anything of it. The next day in the paper, the Memphis paper, was an article titled, you got it, the Million Dollar Quartet, and it took off from there. These guys really became legends. Like I said, this was early on in all their careers, and they continue on for years and years and years, and these guys are the foundations, so much so, of rock and roll. And with the Million Dollar Quartet came a musical called the Million Dollar Quartet that I've seen. It's fantastic. It's about this event. It's not everything that happened, but there's some things, I don't want to say made up, but some things added to it, but it's still a fantastic musical if you ever get a chance to see it. Now, to some people, it might just seem like a bunch of guys that lived a long time ago, and, you know, lived a long time ago, who cares? Those of us who know a little bit about rock and roll, and hopefully a lot of you do, know how important these four guys are. Their impact is still felt today. Elvis Presley, king of rock and roll. Johnny Cash, the king of country. Carl Perkins, king of rockabilly. And Jerry Lee Lewis, who is still alive, by the way, the undisputed king of the piano and of rockabilly piano. So this was legendary. This truly is considered one of the most important events in rock and roll history. December 4th, 1956. Don't forget it.